children, how are you all? Children, some students are not taking the study seriously. They are not still sending the assignments. I request them all to please be sincere in your work because these assignments will help you out to gain marks in the examination. Children, we were doing ratio and proportion chapter, so I will continue that only. Today, I will do question number 6 of exercise 6.2. Now, the question is that we have to find the third proportional to the numbers 36 and 18. Now, we will assume that let the third proportional be x. That means 36, 18, 18 and x are in continued proportion. So that means 36 ratio 18 is in proportion with 18 ratio x. So that means 36 upon 18 equals to 18 upon x. We can cross multiply. So this becomes 36 multiplied by x equals to 18 multiplied by 18. Cross multiplication. So x becomes 18 multiplied 18 divided by 36 because here it is multiply and going to opposite side the sign changes. Multiply will become divide. So 18 into 18 divided by 36. So 18 twos are 36 and 2 nines are 18. So 9 is the third proportional to 36 and 18. Now question number 7. The ratio between the length and width of a rectangular sheet of paper is 7 ratio 5. If the width of the sheet is 20.5 cm, find its length. Here the length is not given to you, but the width is given. So let the length be x cm. And the ratio between length and width is 7 is to 5. The order should be the same. The length we have taken to be x and the width is 20.5. So we will write x ratio 20.5 equals to 7 ratio 5. You cannot change the order. Order will remain the same. Length is to width is equals to length is to width. That means x upon 20.5 equals to 7 upon 5. Same way cross multiply. X multiplied by 5 becomes 7 multiplied by 20.5. So x is equals to 7 multiplied by 20.5 divided by 5. I have cut this. 5 ones are 5 and 5, 4.1s are 20.5. So 7 multiplied by 4.1 becomes equals to 28.7 centimeters. So this is the required length of the rectangular sheet. Now children, I will start exercise 6.3 in which you will study about unitary method. Now what is unitary method? Unit means one. In this method, first the value of unit quantity, that is one quantity is calculated and then the value of the required quantity is determined. Like suppose you go to a shop and suppose you are buying toffees. The cost of 20 toffees is rupees 100. So how will you find the cost of one toffee? You will divide 100 by 20, which means rupees 5. So what will be the cost of 30 toffees? Now you will multiply 5 with 30. So the cost of 30 toffees is rupees 150. So this is called the unitary method. First you find the value of one quantity, then you find the value of other quantities. First you will divide, then you will multiply. Now question number 1 is that 6 bowls cost rupees 90. What would be the cost of 10 such bowls? Now cost of 6 bowls equals to rupees 90. Therefore cost of 1 bowl equals to rupees 90 divided by 60. First you will divide. Therefore, cost of 10 bowls equals to rupees 90 divided by 60 into 10. So rupees 150 is the answer. Question number 2 is, 10 pencils cost rupees 15. How many pencils can be bought with rupees 72? We have to find the number of pencils, so we will keep it on the right hand side. Pencils bought with rupees 15 equals to 10. Pencils bought with rupee 1 is 10 divided by 15, because with rupee 1 we will get less pencils, so we will divide. And pencils bought with rupees 72, now we will multiply because we will get more pencils. So 10 upon 15 multiply by 72. 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, and 3 24s are 72. 2 multiply by 24 is 48. So 48 pencils can be bought with rupees 15. Now question number 3. Now children, there is another method using the formula of ratio by which you can solve these questions. I will tell you question number 3. 400 grams cake cost 80 rupees. So how much would be 1.5 kilogram cake cost? First of all, we will convert 1.5 kilogram into gram, because the first value is in gram. 1.5 kilogram equals to 1.5 into 1000 gram. So it becomes 1500 grams. Now 400 ratio 80 will be equals to 1500 ratio x. We have assumed the cost of 1500 cake is x. Let the cost of 1500 gram equals to rupees x. Cost of 400 gram was rupees 80. So 400 ratio 80 equals to 1500 ratio x. That means 400 upon 80 equals to 1500 upon x. Cross multiply, 400 into x equals to 1500 into 80. So x becomes 1500 into 80 upon 400. Two zeros cut for 20 za, so 300. So the cost of 1.5 kilogram cake is rupees 300. Now children, you can use this method also, or you can use unitary method, like cost of 400 grams equals to rupees 80, cost of 1 gram is 80 upon 400, and cost of 1500 gram is 80 upon 400 multiplied by 1500. So you will get the same answer. Question number 4 is, a man earns rupees 18,000 in 3 months. How much time would he take to earn rupees 30,000? Let the time to earn rupees 30,000 be x months. That means 18,000 ratio 3 equals to 30,000 ratio x. So 18,000 upon 3 equals to 30,000 upon x. Cross multiply. So x becomes 30,000 into 3 upon 18,000, which is equals to 5 months. Second part is, now we have to find the money which he earns in 7 months. So let the money earned in 7 months be rupees x. Then 18,000 ratio 3 equals to x ratio 7. See, here we have put x here at the extreme, because these are the months and these are the money. So money, months. 18,000 upon 3 equals to x upon 7. So x becomes 18,000 into 7 upon 3. We cut it. So we will obtain rupees 42,000. So the money earned in 7 months is rupees 42,000. Now children, you will complete this exercise 6.3.